and the incarcerated.
Hey. Seems like everywhere you go, you bump into people, huh?
That's how it is.
Wonder why. And this is only 33%.
Business. It's a business.
33% up?
Yeah, go ahead.
No, sir, I'm just talking to this gentleman. But every time I look up, there's another guy. There's another guy. There's another guy.
They shouldn't stay right too close to the damn door.
Let's go outside.
Yeah.
Oh. What do you think about his concept?
Oh, it's nice. Nice looking building. I mean, nice looking room. I looked at everyone on the little room. I like that. That stained glass I got in there.
Did you see that?
Hey.
Yes.
Over here?
Uh-huh. I was going to say, I think you got another.
Go back in there. Here. Go back in there and look to the right.
Yeah. Thank you all.
Thank you. Well, I want to tell you something. It took some heavy, heavy investigating for me to be able to finally figure it out of everything that has occurred here. Everything that has occurred here in my life in the past 30 years, you know, I told you that I got to know this gentleman 30 years ago, or a little over 30 years ago,
right?
Whenever he basically first came into town, and wasn't none of this here. They barely had a post office.
Yeah, making a name for himself.
And he built that one restaurant.
Yeah.
It caught a fire.
Yeah.
Then they devoted his time towards another restaurant that was sitting in the same spot this one here's in. It wound up catching a fire. And if I'm not mistaken, the nightclub that he had in Paducah caught a fire too.
Oh, sounds like
there's a pattern.
Ours.
I believe it did. Now, I may be wrong about the nightclub.
Well, let's just say...
I know the nightclub...
Insurance.
I know that the nightclub had a big lawsuit to it because of somebody either getting stabbed or killed or something there at the nightclub. And I don't know for sure if the nightclub itself caught a fire or if they just immediately closed it down to begin with because of a lawsuit.
Right.
But... in my investigations, this is running right now, okay? And I may have gotten you on the film.
Oh, that's okay.
During the time that I was up here fasting and praying for a revival, and I was doing a lot of my investigation work, I would bump into this individual, and they would tell me this story.
Sure.
I'd bump into this individual. They tell me this story. And I'd bump into this individual. They tell me this story. You know, after a period of 30 years, you start running the dots together. And eventually, if you got a pattern, of everybody's story being similar towards what actually occurred here, that was the desecration of a whole generation of people whenever President Kennedy flew over this peninsula in 1963 and deemed it as it being a total disaster and turned it into a federal refuge, which basically run everybody else that had done already been hurt and violated with the TVA deal that went on back in the 30s.
Yep.
Whenever you hear the same story again and again and again and again, that it was the mob that had something to do with the death of JFK, because shortly after the airplane flew over this property and this was desecrated into a federal refuge, you start putting these dots together, because this one's got the same testimony, or this one's got the same pattern of the same testimony as this one does. And whenever I say this one and this one, I'm just not talking about an area confined within a mile area or a 5 mile area. I'm talking about a 100 mile area. I'm getting the same testimonies in Dover, Tennessee, as I am all the way up here in freaking Cumberland River or the Kentucky Lake. Whenever you're going out to various places and getting the same type of testimony 100 miles on either side of the peninsula,
it's the truth.
There must be something to the story.
Sure. There's got
to
be at least 80% truth.
And there, all of a sudden, you pop up a restaurant valued at what? Several million dollars.
Maybe.
Stuck out here in the middle of the country off the Tennessee River, and you got a room that's dedicated to the president's suite.
Yeah.
See the dots?
Oh, yeah.
See the dots? JFK, people being run out of this area.
Oh, yeah.
See, TVA put the hurting on them in the 30s.
It did.
Because they basically widened the river on not just the Tennessee River side, but also on the Cumberland side, that caused a bunch of them to either abandon and go inland, or they had to move inland on the peninsula. Well, that aggravated and agitated a great deal of people's lives.
I thought TVA is the only thing that helped after the Depression.
TVA was a big thing through Hoover, of the movement that helped during the Depression towards getting people
back
working
work.
And going. Yes, yeah. Kind of like the Hoover Dam. You're absolutely right. But it was also TVA that helped ruin millions and millions and millions of people's lives for people to have electricity that they have today, too.
Yep.
You keep in mind, there was a lot of sacrificing that went on during that time of people that had to pick up stakes and move out, either that or be flooded.
Yep.
And some of them actually died up here on the peninsula because they didn't give up.
Yeah.
They didn't give up their land.
Yeah.
All in the name of progression.
Huh? Oh, no, we won't even come anywhere close to topping a property, the water level line.
Well, they was offering at the time top dollar, which at the time was about $16 an acre. But the way that they measured ground back then was basically stepping off 300 steps this way, 300 steps this way, 300 steps this way. And so a lot of those people on a deed that would show that they owned 100 acres, TVA was actually going in and taking over 120, 130 acres.
Sure.
Because it never was measured out properly to begin with.
Yeah.
In the late 1800s, driving into the early 1900s, as far as conservation. Conservation wasn't near like it is today.
Nope.
Today, they can tell you within a square inch of where the line's supposed to be.
Yep.
A square inch. A matter of fact, that's how they sell property in your bigger cities now. They don't sell it by the acre. They don't sell it by the yard. They'll sell it by the square foot.
Yeah.
And possibly in New York City and other bigger areas, Miami, Los Angeles.
They break it down to by inch.
Probably break it down to the inch.
Yeah. California, New York.
But the guy had a dream, a vision,
yep,
of what he was going to do. And I do credit him on the fact that he done it.
Yep.
So I thought I'd tell you my story of the reason why that I spent so much time up here doing so much investigation work. I stayed up here in total about a year.
Yeah.
This just opened this year.
Yeah.
About, seemed like it was in February. Maybe somewhere right around Christmas time, I think it opened.
Probably, yeah.
Yeah. And the day of the opening, there were so many people here, you couldn't hardly walk.
Oh, I bet.
It was. That was before the COVO hit.
Mm-hmm.
Now, since the COVO hit, it's dampened everything back down.
Yep, numbers are dwindling. Yeah, where are you going?
It's a real beauty.
Yeah, there's a few of them out here.
A Mexican cutie. How we got here, I don't have a clue. Do you?
Oh, innocent face.
You figure a lot of these girls that you're looking at right here?
Yeah.
Probably been on the yachts, probably been on the boats today.
Oh, yeah.
Been water skiing or whatever.
Oh, yeah. Been nice and clean.
Went to their hotel.
Clean, clammy, and musky.
Or they got cleaned up. Now they want to get out on the evening and come down here. And
yep.
Look at that little boat right there.
Oh, yeah.
That's about a $50,000 rig right there.
It's a nice little ski boat.
Nice little ski boat.
One that I'd want, that I would welcome in my bed. Yeah. Out of five girls, I only welcome one of them into my bed. The rest of them too thick.
Well, I don't welcome none of them into mine.
Well, that ain't gonna mean that. Ain't gonna kick your ass.
I care
up
more
the very
about
next
my
day.
Morals than to invite something like that in my life.
Yeah.
I've done been bitten too many times.
No, me too.
By the same snake.
Me too, but I ain't making the same
by
mistake
by the same
twice.
Snake. Food's decent.
Oh, yeah. Very, very decent.
Did you put your food up?
Yeah. Yeah, put it.